Okay, guys, let me reveal to you rule number one for surds, and that is in terms of multiplication. So if we got two surds multiplied, for example, let's call them A and B. If we multiply them separately, then we will get this big square root of A times B. So for example, let's say we had the square root of, or the surd of, 5 times the surd of 6. That's simply the big square root of 5 times 6, which equals the square root of 30. So that's how we do the multiplication of surds. Now, the square root of 30 is an irrational number. That's like 5.47722555. Instead of writing all those decimals, let's just keep it as square root of 30. It's nicer and neater and tidier. Okay, so that's rule number one. So let's try another example. Let's say we had the square root of 10 times the square root of 5. Now that's simply going to be big square root, which is 10 times 5, which equals 10 times 5 is the square root of 50. Now we know that the square root of 50 is 7.071067812. So that's the square root of 50. It's nice and tidy, small and compact.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmath.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.